Windy up here.
Indeed. Folks walking down.
The ski lift.
You should have been here because we just went over all the wine you'll be drinking for the next several years that was made right here in Rudisheim. We said hello to the grapes.
Thank you.
This is a statue up above Rüsheim. We took the ski lift up here, and this is the statue that's up here.
Bye.
This is the Marksburg Castle that we're about to go up to and go in.
Steiners were politically very important, but they were deeply in debt. They sold the castle to Katzenelnbogen in the same century. Those counts must have been rich. They were wealthy. They added the most. We're walking upstairs, uphill, and we're aiming at a spot battery. So I'm just talking about my boss. This here is the only entrance there is. So he always has to carry shopping bags up this route. He's a great shape. Hesitating because they wouldn't.
A little garden up here in the forecourt.
Unfortunately, this is a good point to prove that. They had comfortable in practice, meaning they had a short distance to reach the latrine, the WC. This in there is not a bathroom, though. They didn't have a bathroom in this castle. So that during the 1600s, during the 30 Years' War, this castle belonged to Hesse, to a Protestant area, and this castle was even occupied peacefully, officially, by the Swedish. So I doubt that Swedish people.
A very narrow staircase going up to the next story. Look at that steep, narrow staircase.
The helmet, it could get threateningly hot, especially during summer season. Breathing at least became easier later on with removable visors like over there. They're still heavy, but now at least you can take a breath and show your face. It was new. Before that, this guy was anonymous. So showing his face not only was good for his health, but also was becoming a salute towards the nobility. So if we're stepping up. Stepping outside into is the whole courtyard. There's nothing else. It was bigger 800 years ago and was cut back when these parts were added 600 years ago here and 300 years ago with this half timber town. One turn, a few centimeters to produce such a pain. They confess anything. The punishments were different from that, technically. They had written laws that could distinguish that. Here we have two punishments. The first is behind the glass, the shame sanction with the masks of shame. The center has that unfortunate example of a long pig's nose. A long pig's nose made of iron. He then became literally, symbolically, a dirty pig. He was presented to a public crowd as the then dirty pig, and he lost his reputation, his social standing. That's it could be heavier than this one, and let it fall from a certain distance in order to break, to smash someone's bones. Beginning with the feet, going up that body. In a second step, you are bound onto the spokes of that wheel with your broken arms and legs, and got hung up, hanging at that wheel. You should.
We're heading over to the cable car stop. We're going to take that cable car across the Rhine to the fortress.
Take the last one.
Cool.
It's the largest playground in the area.
Awesome.
Really? The tip of the viewing platform stretches 10 meters beyond the cliff edge.
This is the Rhine. The Mosel was the one we were walking along.
Were we singing a song?
We parked along the Mosel.
Mosel, Mosel. Yeah.
Were we Moseling?
Huh? What?
What?
There's more weight in this one than there was in that one.
Now.
Well, I don't think it was full. What I do here, I don't want myself.
It's very efficient.
You go faster. Unless you will.
Everyone get ready to hop off.
Yeah. Hop up.
Yeah.
I can't. Somebody put a glass in the way.
Stupid glass. Just get a big rock.
This is the German corner, the Deutsche Ecke, where the Koblenz. The town there, and you can see the Mosel flowing into the Rhine. Make out the difference in the colors of the waters. This is the Elz Castle.
Thank you. for 1 euro.
1 euro.
And the upper part, you know, the left window, you see the dark plate. That's the house where Karl Marx grew up. I showed you the house where he was born in May the 5th, 1818. There was born, he lived 1.5 years. And then his father, Heinrich Marx, he was a lawyer, he bought that house. And that's the house where Karl Marx grew up. And now I can show you the picture about the Karl Marx sculpture. Mm-hmm. 20 feet high. Yeah. Getting it at the end of the little passage where you see the tree. And now they have already political discussions in Berlin about it's too big, Trier will get attached to communism country, city or whatever. And we come live about it.
Because the procedure is always part of the saga.
of that cities who were coming together for the Reformation unity. And here you have another picture this made of bronze, the same scene but what I was showing you at the cathedral, because here you see also Martin Luther with the monk's robe here, and you see the lawyer of the church, and Jan von der Eck, Johann von der Eck, and here you see young emperor Charles V, and the nobles. This is the nuncius. He was sent from the Pope. He was wearing that all in red. Maybe you've seen that in the historical movies. Favorite figure here. She's called the protesting Speier. For example, bishops, and also they were nobles in the world. So, and part of them wanted to go back, but the other part of them, they were protesting. And that to that event, all the Protestants have the name from. Was able to, constructing things to, for memory, to remember him, yeah? And here the
here you always have the same water level. So what's important is that don't give up. It takes about three to taste right. And the name Schlenkel.
Thank you.